Hey everyone, begin by pulling this and putting it over the door. And I think you can then push it so that it's properly touching. That causes them to break through a little bit later. Had you not done it, they'd have broken through at this point, but instead we can make it down to here. Only makes a couple of seconds difference, but the less pressure we're under, the better, because it causes them to break in just a little bit later, and obviously all this smoky stuff will appear a bit later, and so we've got less pressure, less risk of our air running out. So there's a general rule of if the doors have planks of wood over them, there's absolutely no entering, so forget it.
This door is locked.
And if a door doesn't have wood over it and it's locked, then you can get in there, but not immediately. But there are still the loose items lying around, which is obviously important to get, because well, at this stage, this challenge doesn't really change a great deal. I mean, the game doesn't really change a great deal with the added restriction of no kills, because at this stage, although you have guns, you don't have any ammo, and so you're not really able to perform kills. I mean, there was the stealth kill in the previous level, which you could have done, which I obviously didn't do, because that guy was not a mandatory kill. But other than things like that, things don't really change. The added restriction doesn't really change anything at the moment. However, in future levels, things can and do get very nasty, and levels do become quite expensive, and health items do become very important. So that's why I think it's important that you try and do these levels as peacefully as possible. Try to collect as much health as possible. Try to use as little as possible so that you've got as much as you can have in the harder levels. So do these levels as well as you can so that the future levels are not as bad as they could be. So that's all I'm going to try and do, really. Just try and make things as easy as I can. So there's two keys, and I switch the lift on. One key is obviously for the door that leads to the end of the level. One is obviously for the lift, and obviously this switches it on. And yeah, this is just so we can get around quicker and obviously it's quicker and safer. So floor four is where I am, zero is where they are, so I guess I'll start with one. Yeah, floor three was where I got the strength upgrade, I think. Floor four is where I was. Floor zero, I'll get immediately arrested. So that leaves floors one and two, and I'll just go to one, because that way I can just make my way back up to floor two if it isn't this one, and it isn't, because there's planks of wood, so no point trying that. Here it is. Obviously, I'm going to try and get guns and ammo when I'm able to as well, because obviously there are mandatory kills. There are bits where guns are going to be important, and so obviously I need to collect weapons and ammo as well. Obviously, I'm not going to be using it anywhere near as much as I normally would in a normal playthrough of the game. Yeah, I could go back to the lift and take it up, but for some reason, whenever I that small gap that I had to jump over when I got out of the elevator, and I there was that small gap that I had to jump over. Had I returned to the lift, I would have had to have jumped back over that. And for some reason, whenever I do it, I always end up smashing my head onto like the ceiling or something, and then falling down the gap and then getting arrested. So I thought, might as well just go back up. I wasn't under a great deal of pressure. I had most of my air, and so there wasn't really much worry in going back up the other way. And we are brought up to industrial rooftops. So this will be the save point. So thank you everyone for watching, and hope you enjoyed.